Electric vehicle sales have been growing steadily for the past decade, and Elon Musk's Tesla has been at the forefront of this revolution. Last year, Tesla sold more than 145,000 Model 3s, while GM only sold 18,000 Chevy Bolts, and Nissan sold about 15,000 Nissan Leafs. Still, the base Model 3 Tesla currently costs $40,000 and can go as high as $68,900 for the fully spec'd out performance model. So why is a Tesla so expensive? It costs about $28,000 for Tesla to manufacture a single Model 3. That's $18,000 for materials and $10,000 for labor and manufacturing expenses. There are a lot of costs that go into making any car. Sheet metal, glass, seats, airbags. Even though Tesla sells more EVs than anyone else, its competitors sell more cars overall. GM sold 3 million cars in total last year, and Nissan sold 1.5 million. Tesla only sold 245,000. So companies like GM and Nissan get better deals than Tesla when they buy in bulk from parts suppliers. And EVs like the Tesla Model 3 have one major cost that regular cars powered by combustion engines don't. Their batteries. Rechargeable lithium-ion batteries like the ones in the Model 3 or in your cell phone all require four minerals: lithium, cobalt, nickel, and graphite. It costs Tesla about $6,000 to make one battery for the standard 240-mile range Model 3, and about $4,800 of that cost comes from the raw materials. As electric vehicle adoption grows in the next decade, demand for these materials is expected to grow at least fivefold. More than two-thirds of the world's cobalt is mined in the Democratic Republic of the Congo, where human rights groups say child labor and unsafe mines are a major problem. Musk has said that he wants to get cobalt out of Tesla's batteries entirely. The company has already more than halved the amount of cobalt in its batteries, but it's hard to say if or when they will be able to eliminate cobalt entirely. Another major supply chain challenge is China's dominance of the chemical processing industry. As of this year, 51% of lithium processing, 62% of cobalt refining, and 100% of graphite processing is done in China. Any potential trade war with China could really hurt the EV market. China is also where most of the components are put together into lithium-ion battery cells. Two-thirds of battery cell manufacturing is done in China, versus just 10% in the US. But Tesla has an advantage over its EV competitors here because almost all of that 10% comes from Tesla's own Gigafactory 1 outside Reno, Nevada. That being said, Tesla's expertise in EVs enables the company to produce its own battery cells for about three-quarters of the cost of its competitors. The federal government is offering tax rebates to encourage consumers to buy EVs, but because Tesla sold so many cars last year, the tax incentive is starting to be phased out. There is currently legislation on the table that would keep those incentives around longer, and some states like New York and California offer their own tax rebates. With the U.S. tax credit decreasing, Tesla's also starting to shift its sales abroad. In the first quarter of 2019, 52% of Model 3s were sold outside the U.S., compared to just 7% in the last quarter of 2018. The cost of a Model 3 and other EVs will likely drop as battery cells keep getting cheaper to produce. Analysts are predicting that small cars like the Model 3 will be able to compete with gasoline-powered cars without needing any subsidies by 2024.